Just a little bit smaller, but can we improve the accuracy by using the vision encoder? Let's find out. Hello, welcome to my tech farm. My marketing contact and Bambu Lab sent me the vision encoder to test it and to give a proper explanation what is this for and what is this not for. I got this product for free, but there is an additional payment from the Bambu Lab, but this video and the whole channel is sponsored by Polymaker and by my Patreon supporters. Let's start what is this not for. It will not do anything along the Z-axis, and also it will not improve the surface quality, so I will not even test this. It is designed to improve the accuracy along X and Y axis. How, I will explain it later, but let's go back in the time a little bit. Earlier in Marlin printers, we printed these calibration cubes, we measured them, and according to that we changed the E steps, and that's how we changed the accuracy of that printer. I know calibration cube is too small for this, but this was enough at that time. With clippers, we should change the rotation distance. By the way, interesting that these two numbers has to be changed in opposite direction to have the change in the same direction. And now with Bambu Lab printers, we have this vision encoder, of course only with H series. It has a lot of QR codes on it, and the camera will scan it, and it will create some kind of matrix. It works something similar like auto-leveling along the Z-axis. It will touch the surface and create some kind of matrix, and it will compensate it during the printing. And something similar we have here too, only in X and Y directions. And I believe that this method is really good because it is absolute and not relative. For example, we can change the accuracy only in this corner if necessary. I know properly on the H series printers it is not really necessary and it is quite good calibrated at the beginning, but imagine that if we would have something like this on those Delta printers I tested recently. I'm not sure if it is the case with all Delta printers, but for example I could experience different accuracy on different areas of the build surface. I tested this earlier. According to specifications on the website, it improves the accuracy below 50 micrometers. And according to them, paired with Bambu Studio features like auto-hole contour compensation, it enables the injection molding level accuracy for the assembling. Not sure if this is really important purpose of this, but yes, in this case I believe that we will get real circles. But about that accuracy, very important to know that filaments will shrink after they cool down, especially those technical filaments. The best for this is theoretically the PLA, but carbon fibers or glass fibers always helps here. So according to the Bambu Lab, if I want to test the real accuracy of this, I should test it with the carbon fiber filled PLA. I know I always got the comments that I can enter some shrinking compensation in the slicer, for example for the ABS. But this works only with some simple objects, let's say a box. But if you have some complex objects, Hilbert cube or whatever, in that case not every point will move in the same direction after this shrinking. That's why if I really need a dimensional accuracy and a technical filament, I like to use glass or carbon fiber filaments. And another thing which can ruin the accuracy is the moisture in the filament. Just for the testing, I tried to print something from the nylon which was on open air 1 month. And not only that surface is quite ugly, but also it's bigger. Almost half millimeters on this small dimension. The reason for this is the micro water drops in the nozzle, they boil and push out more filament, and with this we have some kind of over extrusion. So it is very important, even with this carbon fiber PLA, to be dried before the use for maximal accuracy. So I believe that bigger changes we can see on bigger objects too, because don't forget this is absolute calibration. And this means I have to print something bigger and measure it. For this, I have, this is the biggest caliper I have. I can measure up to 270 millimeters. It's a vernier caliper, but I still have a good eyes and I know how to read the vernier caliper, only it is not good for the camera. And for a few smaller parts, I try in different corners, and for this, this is the biggest micrometer I have. This is for dimensions between 75 and 100 millimeters. By the way, recently I was shocked to see that not every engineer knows how to read the vernier caliper. Recently I got this pen, marketing from another university, and I was shocked when I saw this vernier scale. Now I understand that a marketing person who ordered this don't know how the vernier scale works, but this was designed by an engineer, and looks like that engineer used only digital calipers, because this is just a decoration. If let's say 4 millimeters would be divided into 5 pieces, in that case, we can have 0.2 millimeters accuracy, which is maybe even reachable with this plastic, or at least it would be good for the education. But as it is now, it is just a decoration. maybe it's only me, but it hurts so much. What's your opinion? I know I have a lot of engineer viewers, especially for this video. Now let's try to imagine some cases where do we need this vision encoder, because in my experience, my H2S is quite accurate as it is now out of the box. But let's say your printer is delivered by Ace Ventura, and maybe it is damaged a little bit, and maybe it is not even damaged equally, a little bit longer in X direction, a little bit less in Y direction, and you need urgently to use it and you don't want to send it back. But in that case, yes, this can happen, it can improve the accuracy in X and Y direction, even if it's a little bit damaged, but it still prints. Okay, joke to aside. Another case I can imagine. Let's say you are using the printer in a garage. On winter, the air cools down to 14 degrees Celsius, on hot summer day above 30 degrees Celsius, and we have this thermal dilatation of the structure of the printer. And then we can use the vision encoder to compensate it to make it accurate in X and Y direction. Of course, the other question is what is the temperature dilatation of this vision encoder? I believe that best accuracy we will get on the room temperature. And again, the other question is when we start with the printing and let's say we heat up inside the air, what will be the thermal dilatation in that case? I'm just guessing, so what's your opinion about this? The third case I can imagine, let's say you're using your printer 10 years now, it wears out a lot, the belt has some prolongation, it is not even equal, and you have some bigger parts, let's say only on this surface, and in this case you can use the vision encoder to improve the accuracy along the X and Y whole surface. Of course, this is extreme, I don't think this will happen, but I'm just guessing, so if you have some better examples, write me a few lines down in the comment section. So how will I test it? Well, of course, I will have a printing before and after this calibration, and I will use the carbon fiber PLA by Bambu Lab, and it will be dried before this. I will print some bigger objects, almost 270 millimeters, because I can measure them with this bigger caliper, and I will have some smaller parts, 90 millimeters, and they will be located in a different position of the bed, and I will measure them with this micrometer. Maybe I will try to print some holes and to see their accuracy, but I believe that this length is the most important accuracy check in this case. It was dried 8 hours on 50 degrees Celsius, and now let's start with the printing on H2S. All default settings for this filament, even the infill and the valves, and this is the 270 mm object first. I will finish all printings and then I will measure them. I notice that very often on the front side of the bed I have a problem with the bed adhesion because this ventilation cold air is hitting it and it is colder significantly. These are 90 mm objects, three of them at once. They are labeled two, left, center and right. This object has a lot of holes and I'm enabling the auto circle contour hole compensation. And this is that object with the holes, and I notice this PLACF is a really dark filament. Very nice printing. Before I move to the calibration, I want another printing from this PLA Basic, only that biggest object. I'm just curious how different will be the shrinking. Okay, and now it's time for the calibration. This goes out, and vision encoder goes in. And don't forget to remove the protection foil from it. It's a little bit smaller than the full area, so the calibration will be done only on this surface. Calibration, motion accuracy calibration. Start. These are those steps and it will take 7 minutes. Probably it asked me to close the door. The LED lights are turned off for better accuracy and it is scanning the surface now. It's finished. This is the final result, only I'm not sure how to understand this. Okay, vision encoder goes out and the build plate goes back. And now let's reprint those test objects. This is a 70 mm object and I'm using the same G-codes here. 90 mm objects and the last object with the holes. It's time for the measuring, I'm not even sure what will be visible on the screen, so I will just present in the video one measuring for each object. This one is printed before the calibration, in X direction. 269.6 mm. And this one is printed after the calibration, in X direction. 269.5 mm. This is pretty basic, just for curiosity. 269.48 mm. Before calibration in Y direction, 269.52 mm. In Y direction, after the calibration, 269.5 mm. And now those 90 mm objects, and in the video I will include only these ones on the right back side, because on this picture I could see the biggest corrections in this position. My micrometer is calibrated with this 75 mm gauge, and I'm wearing a gloves because to reduce the thermal dilatation until I'm holding the micrometer. I don't have a stand for it yet. Maybe I could print one. In X direction, 89.82 mm. After the calibration, 89.83 mm in X direction. Before the calibration in Y direction, 89.87 mm. After the calibration in Y direction, 89.84 mm. Just one more measuring in the video. In the center in X direction, before the calibration, 89.79 mm. And after the calibration in X direction, 89.81 mm. On the left side in X direction, 89.86 mm. After calibration, 89.82 mm. All these test objects are measured, and I will analyze the numbers later. Now let's see this with the holes, and don't forget, I enabled here that circle out-to-hole compensation. And for example, these holes are 22 mm in diameter, but always a little bit bigger. Only the first one is exactly 22 in the design. And these ball bearings are 22 mm theoretically, but they are always 1 or 2 hundredths smaller. So usually in design I make these holes 0.2 mm bigger. In that case I know it is tight fit, but let's see. This one is exactly 22 in design, and I can feel that I can press it in. So really tight, but this is before the calibration. And let's see the after the calibration. For the filling, completely same. So probably all others are bigger and they will be loose. Yeah. So in this case I couldn't experience any difference in this calibration. Just quick check, this is this biggest hole in X direction, 50.06, in Y direction, 50.09. And this one is after the calibration in X direction, 50.03, in Y direction, 50.02. And now my favorite part, analyzing the numbers. These are directly measured numbers, and then from this I prepared the table where I measure the error in percentage, the difference from the perfect ideal dimension. And we can see that before calibration the error was smaller compared to after calibration. I was thinking, how is this possible? Now probably the reason for this is that before calibration it was a little bit bigger, and after shrinking of the material it was actually closer to that ideal dimension compared to after calibration. And then I noticed one more thing. Theoretically, the difference between the X and Y dimension should be zero under perfect conditions. And this is independent from the shrinking. So I prepared this table, and that we can see on this graph. So with the orange, we can see the difference between X and Y dimensions after calibration, and with the blue before the calibration, and we can see that it is noticeably bigger. Now, this is not too big anyway. Just a reminder, those 50 micrometers they mention on their website, which is thinner than human hair, it is 0.05 millimeters, and basically only this one dimension is out of this range. So even without calibration, this is extremely accurate machine.
So let's go step by step. First of all, I think it is doing something and it will improve the accuracy of the printer. I mean, if it will get the command to move 100 millimeters, it will remove 100 millimeters, minus the line thickness. But I could measure this only by measuring the same dimension in X and Y direction, because it is independent from the shrinking. because this vision encoder don't compensate the shrinking of the filament. Do you remember those E-steps I mentioned at the beginning? Maybe they are still better because let's say we print something 200 millimeters, measure it and do some corrections in the E-steps and reprint, and that accuracy may be even better because it compensates the shrinking too. Of course, that's only for that one filament, and if it will absorb some moisture, then it will be changed. Here we can compensate this shrinking in the Bambu Studio. Now, do you need this vision encoder? Well, BambuLab will not like my answer, but it's their fault basically, because the H2S in this case is quite accurate out of the box. And the improvement will be there, but it is very, very hardly measurable. So maybe you should save some money and buy, high temperature AMS. That would be my recommendation. But who knows, maybe by time, if it wears out, or maybe you are printing in cold, hot environment, and maybe in that case it is good to have a vision encoder to check the accuracy, motion accuracy in X and Y direction. Currently that's my personal opinion, so I know I have a lot of NGR viewers. Am I missing something? Write me a few lines down in the comment section. If you still decide to buy the vision encoder, I will place an affiliate link down in the description. Thank you for watching this video until the end, and happy printing!